This next contest is scheduled for 6 rounds in the heavyweight division. Introducing first, boxing out of the blue corner to my left, wearing the red trunks with white trim. His record impressive, 13 wins against only 4 defeats. He comes to us all the way from Guadalajara, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, Diego Dominguez Gutierrez. And his opponent, standing directly across the ring, fighting out of the red corner to my right, wearing blue trunks with yellow trim. His record, impressive. 4 wins, 0 defeats, 3 big wins by way of KO. He currently lives in Los Angeles, California, by way of his homeland in the Ukraine. Please welcome to me, Andrii. Rampage! No, it's Steve. 6 rounds, heavyweights.
All right, can't wait for this one.
Yeah, a couple of big boys.
How tall is Novytskyi?
Novytskyi's about 6'6", I think.
All right.
Well, he was just a hair shy, a little bit shorter than Sergey. Sergey was 6'9", so here we go.
And again, Gutierrez, great record. You wouldn't imagine this would be an easy fight for either man.
Yeah, good test for Andrii.
Andrii definitely the taller, longer fighter. See if he's going to be able to utilize that reach, pop that jab.
Dominguez took a look back and looked to see where the ropes were, getting a feel for how big this ring is. Good job getting under those punches. Sweeping left hook by Gutierrez.
I like the big tattoo that goes down his shoulder there. All we need is love.
Oh, really? Nice. And Andre's got this circling style with his jab hand to kind of lull you into a little bit of to kind of keep you guessing on where it's coming from. So you can throw the jab, you can throw the hook, to get power on all of them.
Yeah, good body shot there for Novytskyi.
A nice left hook to the head as Gutierrez was coming in also. Watch him circle that jab hand. It keeps it moving. It doesn't stay still. Keeps it moving. So you don't know if it's going to come as a hook, straight. It's that time it's straight. His coach loves it. Yeah, he's finding a home with that straight jab. Keeps it moving. Another one. That's 3 times in a row he hit him with that jab. And that will make Gutierrez a little bit desperate to get some action going, which is happening right now. Unfortunately, what happens then is you step into a big right hand followed behind that jab.
Well, Gutierrez is moving just fine.
Yep.
Definitely looks like a professional boxer in there.
Nice combo through the gloves of Gutierrez. He's trying to throw that punch that Michael Bulger threw. Trying to knock him out with a body shot. Novytskyi looks very composed. Look how he was born to do this. Watch that right hand follow up. There we go.
And it looks like his nickname is Rampage.
Yeah.
Which is such a great nickname.
They're actually down in Orange County, too.
Okay.
Where Rampage Jackson was living for a while. Good 3-piece combo there.
Nice jab there from Novytskyi.
They're good punches, but nothing's hitting. They hit all gloves.
10 seconds.
Oh, he went for the double leg. That wasn't a double leg, but I think he stunned him.
MMA's not for a little while longer.
Yeah, what do you think? Gutierrez against Gulliver? Battle of the G's? Yeah, Novytskyi's doing really good. He's doing everything he needs to do. He's the taller, longer fighter. So obviously he's got to use his reach and his jab and pick him apart.
Right.
And he's doing that.
Gutierrez. What does he need to do? Leap in and try to hit and connect with something, and he's trying. He's doing the job. He's doing what he needs to do. He's just not, he's not connecting with anything. And the game plan is being better executed by Novytskyi. That's just that.
Yeah, I mean, it's got to be really challenging to close that distance to get inside of the jab that Novytskyi has. And he's been doing a good job of, you know, keeping the pressure on as well. So,
yeah, you keep him away with that jab. And, you know, I mean, they both, everybody knows the game plan.
Yeah.
Right? Both fighters know it. It's a matter of execution at this point.
Round two of potential six here. And, again, Novytskyi takes the center, backing Gutierrez up.
The funny thing I saw Gutierrez a couple of times, more than once, he looked back to see where the ropes are. And that tells me he's used to fighting in a smaller ring, because he's like, I should be on the ropes, and it's not there, but you got to be – oh, good. Good jab by Novytskyi. But that tells me he's not – he's a little bit unsure.
Another good shot from Novytskyi. He was able to get through there.
Yeah, he's, I think his coach told him, you're hitting the jab, start with that right hand. Nice hook combo.
Oh, good body shot.
I like that he threw one combo, didn't really space, and he hit another one. He hit two combos back-to-back with very little time in between the two. You can keep that jab to open up his whole game. Jab. He's going to come with that right hand and follow with a hook. I think might be calling for an uppercut. Yeah, to the body, straight to the body. Circling that jab hand, his lead hand.
Minute 20 left in round two.
He's going to the body. He's going to look to go to the body. There he goes. Coach is calling for it. Downstairs, upstairs. Fans are being treated to some good boxing tonight.
Yeah, no doubt. We still have one more to go. Nikki Tejada and Timer Miles.
Yeah.
Up next.
A little bit of fancy footwork by Gutierrez.
And Novytskyi lands a couple of nice shots.
Yeah, right after he did that. This is a six-round fight, and we're in the second with less than 30 seconds to go. And this uppercut just barely missed.
Right.
On the ropes, body.
Gutierrez, yeah, tells him to keep bring it.
Come on, keep it coming. Looking to counter some of that when he comes here. Gutierrez will look to throw that big left hook. Here it is. I can see that Gutierrez is kind of like doing a little bit of rope-a-dope where he stay on the ropes and let him hit him a couple of times after he's done.
Yeah.
If he doesn't hurt him, he jumps in with that big left hook.
He looked a little frustrated there at the end of the round.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's clear as day that Novytskyi's up 2-0 at this point, right?
Yeah.
He's won both 100%. Rounds. So what does Gutierrez need to do to change what's happening in there?
He needs to win the next round, first of all.
Well, how does he do that?
Well, again, he's outclassed a little bit. He's outsized with the reach.
That's the biggest thing that I
see. So in his corner, you're either telling him, you know, counter. And they're looking at his coach. Sorry about that. His coaches are looking at, like, what is he doing? He's throwing a two-piece combo. Okay, after the two-piece, throw a hook.
Yeah.
Here we go. Novytskyi's going to stay with the jab.
Round three. And again, Novytskyi putting the pressure on early.
When he backs him up, I get a little scared for Gutierrez because now he's going to start taking some damage. But Gutierrez seems to be happy to back up against the ropes. That tells me he's going to counterpunch, right? If he's happy to go back to the ropes, then he's also – then he's there, he's going to come fighting back off those ropes. Now Gutierrez has the center of the ring.
Yeah, this is new.
And a little bit of a tie-up. Referee not liking what she's seeing. A little bit of the headlock, a little bit of dirty boxing.
Gutierrez, nice shot to the body there.
Yeah, that was borderline kidneys. All right, see, that's what Gutierrez, now he's mouthing to him too. He's like, all right, here comes that Andy Ruiz.
Right.
Throwing those big looping punches. This is an experienced fighter.
Oh, yeah. Got a great record, 13-4.
Yeah. Just very hard to get inside that reach. That's a huge, that's a wingspan more than a reach.
And I'm wondering if he's thinking maybe a little bit of gamesmanship might get Novytskyi off his game. But,
yeah.
Novytskyi with some clean shots landed right there.
Well, you know what he did? He woke Novytskyi up.
Yeah.
Novytskyi's, you know, you're not going to sit around and wait for this guy to land one of those big haymakers.
And Gutierrez is busted up. He's got some blood coming from his nose,
above his left eye. Left eye, for sure. So he cut him. He cut him a couple times with that combo. And Novytskyi doesn't even look like he's breathing heavy, to be honest. A couple of shots just missed there. But he's got him on the corner. He needs to put him back on the ropes and take care of him. But Gutierrez coming forward and taking the center of the ring. That jab's getting through. That jab is hurting him.
40 seconds left in round three. Oh, Novytskyi's landed some more big shots. I'm starting to see Gutierrez take some deep breaths, too.
Yeah. Oh, nice counterpunch by Novytskyi.
Oh.
That's wobbled him. He took a knee. Looks like he hurt his right hand. He's shaking his right hand. His hand's broke. I think he hurt his hand.
Yep.
Fight's over.
That's it.
Yeah.
Stoppage.
His right hand or his wrist or something hurt.
Andrii Novytskyi looking impressive in there. Stays undefeated. Moves to 5-0.
Impressive. Yeah, good work by Andrii Novytskyi. Stayed on it.
Yep. I mean, he had all the intangibles in there to go in and win this fight. The reach was significant, and that was really the difference.
Yes, yeah, the deciding factor. I tell you, Ryan, I'm looking out at the crowd, and it is packed right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, from the upper decks down to the orchestra, crowded.
One more boxing match to go. Then we have one grappling contest, and then we move to the MMA.
Yeah, we got Nicky Tejada coming up, and he's a rising prospect in the Boston boxing scene right now. And I think we're going to have Sean Farley on the mic as well. I think Sean Farley is coming over right now to come get on the headset. Yeah, we're blessed to have Sean Farley coming with us here.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, The end comes at 2 minutes and 57 seconds of round number 3. Referee Melissa Duffy calls a halt to this contest on the advice of the blue corner. Your winner, you got to be KO and still undefeated, Andre Quintage Novytskyi.
All right, Novytskyi gets it done. Again, stays undefeated, moves to 5-0.